development. This one is, this middle one is coronal. Coronal view in the chassis. And the lower one is axial view in the chassis. So when we are studying this, always we have to correlate with embryological development. So in embryological development, the first at the ectoderm, aortic placoid develops. Next is aortic pit. Next is aortic vesicle. That is at the fourth pit. Aortic vesicle is at fourth pit. That means our common cavity is at fourth pit. Next to this aortic vesicle, endolymphatic sac is protruded. And after protrusion of this, this happens in the fifth pit. After protrusion of this, in the sixth week, this is divided into vestibular part and trochlear part. In the seventh week, this vestibular part divides further into ventricle and semicircular canals. And this trochlear part divides into saccule and trochlear duct. And again it turns, at eighth week, the complete wound of curve develops. So this is the normal embryology. So whenever you are studying these abnormal cochleas, three things happen: arrest, aberration, or combination. Any one of these. So if you understand this arrest first, then these things we can assess from the radiology. So first arrest. So again, in radiology, cochleas, vestibule, semicircular canals, IAC, and vestibular tract. Each part we have to think whether it is normal or plasia or hypoplasia or it is there. These things are the fundamentals required reading the lecture series of this cochlear implant anatomy. Next, coming to this coronal, this was given much importance in Jochler. The original Professor Jochler published this abnormal cochleas. So when the arrest happens at aortic placoid, that becomes the mission of my implant. So at internal artery canal level, only a small mass present. That is aortic placoid. Arrest at aortic placoid. Further, if the arrest happens at aortic vesicle, it becomes common cavity. Literature clearly defines common cavity small, common cavity large. So at the fourth week, around fourth week, it is small common cavity and large common. So at the same time, two projections also present. This one is, this left side projection is lateral semicircular. This superior projection is superior semicircular. Superior semicircular, like in our pediatric DNA structure only. Suppose if the arrest stops at fifth peak, at endolymphatic protrusion, without dividing into vestibular part and cochlear part, that is what cochlear ectasia. That means cochlear part not developed, arrested at fifth week. This one is, this corresponds to this. This corresponds, articulation vesicle corresponds to common cavity. Now at the sixth week, vestibular part to cochlear part, and it is divided. So at the only a bud develops, that is, it is in the process of developing cochlear. That is called bud stage. Professor Jochler, this label is as bud, that is cochlear hypoplasia, CVL. And further protrusion of cochlea develops and EF develops is called cochlear hypoplasia mild. Cochlear hypoplasia means the whole cochlea and inner ear structures are smaller size than the normal size. They are smaller. That is cochlear hypoplasia. And in the process of developing at 7th week, if the internal architecture is incomplete, that is called incomplete partition, IP, incomplete partition. The Jochler labeled it as, CVL and mild. So when there is no partition, that becomes an IP, incomplete partition 1. When only basal turn partition is there, basal turn and middle turn partition is there, is IP2. That is the Jochler labeled as mild and severe. Sinagrodu in 2002 paper, he published as IP1 and IP2. Normally, in coronal section, only 1.5 turn is the axial, the axis between the vernal section and the rotation of the cochlea towards the apex side, that leads to appreciation of only 1.5 turn, even normal cochlea. So this is the coronal section. Now let us compare this coronal with axial. So same, if the arrest happens at aortic record, this is my Meckel's, same here also, only a small mark is seen. In this there is no option of cochlear implant. Directly you have to implant the alternate section. Suppose if the common cavity is there, here in axial section, you will see the common cavity and its communication to the IAC. So IAC is directly connected to the common cavity. So that is the reason why our airway may protrude into this IAC. That is the potential disadvantage why we are doing the surgery in this common cavity. Next is cochlear ablation. These two are cochlear ablations. That means, so you may get confusion with this cochlear common cavity and cochlear ablations. One, how to differentiate? This is smaller in size. Cochlear ablations are smaller in size. I mean, smaller than this common cavity. Another thing is, there is no cochlea here. To draw a line at the IAC, there is no cochlea anterior to the IAC. Only vestibule and lateral semicircular canal present. This vestibule is small, sometimes it is large. That is cochlear ablation. Coming to cochlear hypoplasia, that means the whole inner ear and the cochlea is smaller size than the normal. So again, there are three types. One, two, three. This bird, ear bird, only bird shape. And cochlear hypoplasia, they label it as CH. CH1, CH2, CH3. CH1 is only bird. CH2 is cystic. Small notches present like normal cochlea or simple expanded bud. And the molars is present. That is the difference between CH2 and IP3. That I will explain later. This is cystic. CH2 is cystic. CH3 is smaller in size, smaller cochlea. All the terms are there, but small, or it may be less than 2 terms. This is CH2. What happens is, in cochlear hypoplasia, CH1 and 2 and 3, our CDL, cochlear duct length, is less. So that is cochlear hypoplasia. Coming to IP, incomplete partition. Incomplete partition is our cochlear mature to adult size, but the partition is not there inside the cochlea. So when you see the axial sections, the normal cochlea is seen as basal turns, two basal turns, two middle turns, and apical turns. The middle portion is modulus. So the base of the modulus is cupriform in shape, cupriform, C-like. So that is called in our cochlear implant radiology, COA, cochlear aperture. This is very important in radiology. So this is when we are seeing through the internal auditory canal, IAC level. So in axial view, two levels we will appreciate. One IAC level, one at round window level. So this is also, this is normal, this is also normal. Even though we are not seeing modulus here, this is also normal. It is at round window level. Basal turn, middle turn, and apical. So now coming to abnormalities, IP1 and IP2. IP1 is, see, when the vestibule from here, as it matures, the vestibular size decreases. That means at 7th week, if it arrest happens, the vestibule also at its large than normal. So, in this IP1, both here and vestibular, both the equations are there. And here, there is no partition at all. So there is no partition, no modulus. The cavity is directly connected to the internal auditory canal. Whereas here, IP2, again at the 7th week, that is the reason why you have dilated vestibule. And a small partition is there between the basal turn and the middle turn. That's why you have partition between the basal turns and the middle turn. And middle turn and apical turn are in single cavity. So some surgeons, they call it as moment of time. This is absolutely normal. There is no difference in the insertion of an electrode, IT hook and normal chain. Absolutely normal. So we can tell the parents good prognosis. This IP. And IP3 is the partitions, that is osseous spiral angle is developed, but there is no modulus. This is X-linked and it reaches the adult size. That's why vestibule is normal size. So in IP3, 100% the cavity is connected to the implantatory canal. So the cavity is connected to the implantatory canal in three conditions. One is common cavity, another is IP1, another is IP3. The difference is, the experts saying is, in IP3 it is 100% it is connected X-linked. There is no modulus. So 100% this cavity is connected to the IS. Whereas IP1 and common cavity, sometimes there is basal modulus. Recent Senator 2016, they further classified this into so many types. Modulus, 6 types are there. That I will release in YouTube. So this is IP1, IP2, IP3 at IAC level. Suppose if you see at the round middle, this is IP1, same one. Insert term, middle term, and apical term. There is no partition. So this is at round middle. The same IP2 at round middle. Basal term is there. The partition between the basal term and middle term is there. But there is no partition between apical term and middle term. So this is one and a half cavity at round window level in axial sections. So this is how we have to classify the